Thank you all the chairpersons for your being here and gracing the occasion. I am very much thankful to you, Dr. Verma, that you are said so many nice words about me, because you are such a great person that you will speak so many good things about others. So I am thankful to you. I am thankful to Professor Javed and Dr. Adarsh too, that they are here part of the conference and part of the session. So I would like to speak on the establishment and propagation of forensic nursing science in developing countries. So this is all my experience that how we can do this. So the learning objectives of today are: what are the steps to develop forensic nursing science in a country, and what are the experiences of developing it in a country, and what are the pitfalls which should be avoided? If you will take care, you can develop the forensic nursing science in your own country. So what are the steps for this? Which I have done. So forensic nursing science first is introduced at some place, in some institution, in some university, and then we create awareness of forensic nursing science. So once it is, some program is held, some conference is held, some workshop is held, some seminars are held, then people get the awareness about the forensic nursing science. And it also comes in the media. And usually this leads to a lot of awareness. But this simply awareness doesn't help. So we have to reinforce the thing. We have to start doing the practical things. And then we have to broaden the base from one institute to another, from another to another, from one state to another state, from one country to another country. We have to do this, and then the courses have to be started. Maybe it is just a 12-hour course, or is a 25-hour course, or a 50-hour course, or whatsoever is possible. So don't think that we should start in a very big way. Even the very small courses, they create a lot of awareness in this situation. And then whatsoever courses you are starting, see to it that these are recognized by the regulatory bodies of your countries. So for the Indian Nursing Council in India, similarly, there are the nursing councils, are the various government offices which regulate these studies. So you should take care of that. And then comes the job when the students with the degrees, with the diplomas, with the certificate courses will come, they can have the job. Because if the first jobs are created, then there is no use, because there will be no candidate for that. We faced this thing. So first, the regulatory body should accept these courses, and then the job should be created. It can be created in the different institutes, in the police, in the law forces. So we will talk about that later. And then it should be further expanded. And this is a complete circle by which you can do this. So how we have done this in our country? So in 2002, first time in India, Virginia Lynch, who is the mother of the forensic nursing, so she came to India and she introduced in my institute at Government Medical College, Patiala. So she was first there where all the police officials sitting right to me, next right to me, Virginia, and various judges, advocates, police officials, and all those were present at that time. And then all these were published in the journals, right in the very beginning, 2002-2003. So this was done, and these papers were presented. So these were the journals which at that time were at our state level, but now, of course, it is a national and international participants are there. So then we started doing practical training to the nurses. So we started showing them the postmortem examination. So you see, it was their first class. So many of people are having the handkerchief on their mouth. So that was not a COVID time when people were not wearing the mask and all that, the students. And so the various intricacies of the postmortem examination, they were taught to them at the Government Nursing College, Patiala. So then we went to the other colleges, Dayanand Nursing College, Ludhiana, Guru Har Sai Nursing College, Raikot, Guru Ramdas Nursing College, Hoshiarpur, and Government Nursing College, Amritsar. So we covered all the different corners of our state so that more people come to know about this. Then we took it to that, we went to the different states of the country. We guest lecturer at the ICFMT conference at R India Institute of Medical Sciences, which is the biggest medical institute in our country, and guest lecturer at Patna at the annual conference of Indian Academy of Forensic Medicine. So this is what this Indian Academy of Forensic Medicine in 2003 that awarded for bringing the forensic nursing science to the present level. So then it was in the USA Colorado University where we talked to the forensic nursing students. It was a mutual learning, telling them about our Indian experience and getting back their experience. And so these were their postgraduate students at that time with whom we interacted and planned that how it should be done with the help of the Virginia Lynch sitting right in the sitting in the front. So this was their certificate of that their university where it was I lectured there and coordinated the courses. So this was published on the Indian Academy of International Association of Forensic Nurses. They put this on the edge, and so this was reported with the Dr. O.P. Jisuja and the SSP of the our area. So they were there, and this as was reported. So this was reported in the journal what we were doing at that time. So then we progressed further. So we talked to our university, we talked to our police official, we talked to the advocates, we talked to our director, so that this course should come forward. So in 2005, we did this, and Virginia again was present at this time during this conference. So this is the audience. You can see a big audience of the police official on the left side. You can see in the khaki dress there, they are sitting there. So all the officials, vice chancellors, directors, principals, everybody, you name it, and they were present in this conference. And then a workshop on the rape victim examination was done in 2003. And when the Jennifer and other people, they were present along with Virginia in this conference again next year. And so this was the workshop where the police official, highest police official of our state, along with the director and other persons, again, Virginia Lynch was here. So then we started creating awareness of the forensic nurses to the police officials so that ultimately they are to utilize their services. They have to be comfortable with them. So these police officials were taught, they were taught even about the bite marks and all that. So then in 2006, this forensic nursing science was taken to the South Africa at that time. And this was presented. So this is the Nelson Mandela Medical College and the head of that department. He will be speaking today also in the conference. So this is the vice chancellor of our university where this awareness program was created. The first conference was of this university was of that of forensic nursing science. And then we saw that it is the female police officials who need to know more about the forensic nursing science because they were examining, they were the IOs for the rape cases in most of the circumstances. So they were made aware. So they were trained for this, and you see they are being given the certificate. This is the whole group which took the training at that time, including the police officials, advocates, and other people. So then this was taken through West Bengal, a different state in our country, where we talked about the forensic nursing science. Then it was taken to Mangalore in the south of India. So we took it to the different corners of India to talk about the forensic nurses at this time. And then we started an evaluated program in our institute, Gyan Sagar Medical College and Hospital, where the students were taught about the forensic nursing science. And so you see all these students, they were taking part in this. So they were given a test, and they appeared, even their teachers, they appeared for this examination. And ultimately the certificate distribution ceremony was done, and the forensic nurses who cleared this course, they were given this certificate at that time. So Ms. Nisha Bharati, she was the first forensic nurse in our country. And she is the first forensic nurse in our country who was there, who was looking after the emergency work. So keeping in view all this, I went to USA, and I was happy to see a flag of my country there, a salute to my tricolor flag. So at that time, the IFN Vision Award 2007 was given at the Salt Lake City, USA. And I salute my tricolor, the flag of my country at this occasion. And at that time, I had made a promise to get it started in India and have better workforce of forensic nurses in India than the rest of the world. I did this, made a promise in 2007 and started working on it. So again, we went to the Colorado Technical University and interacted with the nursing students there. So then Virginia Lynch again came back to the Gansagar Nursing College to reinforce these programs. And Professor Glenda and Virginia is here at our nursing college along with our management. And Professor Glenda also spoke at that time. So we had an agreement with Colorado University at that time for the promotion of this study. Then we initiated the Indo-Pacific Academy of Forensic Nursing Science, which was launched in 2009 with its own website. 238 members are present under the patronage. Courses started in India, and 96 students successfully completed this course in Gansagar Nursing College. So then this INPAFNES was got registered. And again, this courses, they remain started. So again, they were evaluated. This is the next batch of the forensic nurses, which came through. Then it was published in the trends in the medical world. So then we had the first conference that is of the forensic nursing science at Gansagar. So here you see Dr. Paramjit Jaiswal. He was our first chief guest at that time. So again, we are happy that he was present in the first conference. And now he is present again at the seventh conference. So we thank him a lot. So the books and journals being released, so that is our audience. So in 2012, so we went to the Rama University, Kanpur. Again, Virginia was there. And we made awareness about this at that time. Again, this was in the Raipur, a different part of India, where we spoke about the forensic nursing science. And then the courses started at Gandhinagar in Gujarat at today. The chief guest is from that university, Gujarat Forensic Science University, and they have started the post-basic diploma in forensic nursing. And requirement for admission is bachelor's degree in nursing with minimum 55% marks. So we did not stop there. We continued our efforts, and 2013, it was at Dahang Kalera. We had another organization, and Professor Carson was the chief guest from USA, was the chief guest at that time. Sitting next to her is the Mr. Rai. He is the top police official of the state at that time. And so this was our audience at that time. So we had a big gathering of 450 people at that time. So our hall was full at that time. And the chief guest is being honored at that time. So then workshop was held at the National Nursing College, Sangrur. And so this is the gathering again at Patiala we had with the theme of globalization in nursing forensic. So these are the state authorities along with our director, our principal and other people present. So this was very well covered in the newspapers and there was a lot of awareness was present. Then the fourth conference of INPAFNES was held with the trend of the current trends and personality development in forensic nursing science at Nightingale Nursing College. So again, we had about 300 delegates at this conference. And so again, the police officials and other forensic pathologists and nurses, they were present, the part of this conference. And then again, we went to a different country in the Saudi Arabia, and they raised the awareness about the forensic nursing science. So again, you can see the flag of my country there. So I am happy to see you. Then we had the fifth conference at Jaipur. In 2019, we had this conference at Jaipur, where about, again, we had 275 delegates. And then that is the journal release of the International Journal of Ethics, Trauma and Victimology that is supported by INPAFNES at this conference. And then at the sixth conference, theme expansion of forensic nursing science in social services at MM Nursing College, Solon, it was introduced. So this conference was a big success with Vice Chancellor Sir being there in the ceremony. So this is again the journal being released at that conference with the registrar of the nursing council there, with the vice chancellor, Dr. Ravinder Singh being there, Dr. Paramjit and Varinder Kaur being there. So again, this was the audience. So again, it was a big success at that time. So then the Krishna Institute of Medical Sciences, Karad, was there. And so we told about the forensic nursing at that time, and these were the potential forensic nurses at there. So then we started with the Dr. Ranjit Singh Introduction and Development of Forensic Nursing Science. That was an online thing because now the COVID had started. We did not stop there. And then the Forensic Nursing and Humanitarian Forensics. So again, this was done at the Modi University, probably, I think, Jain University, it was there. So this forensic talents, they organized practice of forensic nursing in India post-COVID-19 scenario. So that we talked about again, and international conference of, and the journey and scope of forensic nursing in the Indian subcontinent were discussed. So this International Journal of Ethics, Trauma and Victimology is regularly publishing in the articles on forensic nursing science and prospects of being a patient, expectation, rights and responsibilities. So these were the other papers. So forensic nursing in humanitarian practice and role of forensic nurses in the mortuary. So they were discussed. So again, the Journal of Nursing and Patient Safety, it is an international journal, and forensic nursing practice in the post-COVID era, that was published. So the biggest thing, and I am happy to share with you, that the forensic nursing science has been introduced in the fifth semester, and it is a 25-hour course, and many different aspects of the forensic nurses are included. So that is the great achievement by the efforts of all our members. And today we are with you talking about the advancement in forensic nursing science and practice. And so this book, Forensic Nursing Science, A Global Health Initiative in Developing and Developed Countries, is available at Amazon.com, both in three forms, ebook, paperback, as well as the hardcover. But there are some pitfalls which should be avoided. So I would like to say that there is a reinforcement, should not be weak. All stakeholders should be kept into confidence and involved at all the stages. It should be a continuous process. Good leadership in nursing professional should be identified early in the stage, and a good team of all stakeholders should be developed. Forensic nursing is not a replacement of any field, but it is a booster to the other field. It should always be remembered. And I would like to conclude that you should have a passion. You need to work hard on it. You should develop a plan for initiating forensic nurses, first in your states, then in your countries, and make all the stakeholders aware about this. Don't leave any stakeholders untouched. Collaborate with forensic medicine experts and police, start the courses, and jobs will come automatically. Thank you very much. If you have questions, you can ask me right now, or you can write to me at darkishkoria@gmail.com, or you can WhatsApp me at 9198720208 40. Thank you very much.